George of Boxing now here with Eddie Hearn. Eddie, first of all, how have you been?
Been good, non-stop, back and forward to Riyadh a lot. Of course, press conference yesterday for Fury Usyk and a big press conference today. And a massive show on Saturday in Manchester. Great to have a big UK show back on UK soil. I'm really looking forward to it.
Well, obviously, we'll start with today's press conference. It kind of was very mellow, and then all of a sudden Regis whips out his phone and hell broke loose after that. Did you expect that?
No, from Regis? I was like, I wrapped the presser up, and then he just went, whoa, 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 and I thought, oh, blimey, where are we going here? And, you know, I didn't realise it was a voice note. I thought it was actually an interview, which was a bit naughty. But listen, you know, all's fair in love and war, and he wanted to try and get a little bit of a mental edge, and everyone's talking about it, so I guess it's got to be good for the fight. It's a really, really good fight. Really good fight, and going to be a great crowd here at Co-op Live. You know, first time there's been a boxing event here. Can't wait.
Do you think it'll affect the relationship between Jack and Sam at all? Or do you think it'll just brush it off?
The problem is that people pull up interviews and things people have said all the time. Mm. A lot changes over time. Like, this was at a time where he didn't even know Jack.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, I've said things about fighters who I've sort of changed my mind on, got to know, they've had great performances. But I reckon 2 years ago, maybe a bit longer, Regis was a big favourite to beat Jack Catterall.
But he's 3-1 now, you know.
Yeah, what, Regis? Mm. Yeah, I don't think he's now. I think he's the underdog.
Yeah.
But it's a very, very tough, dangerous fight. And it just added a little bit of spice, didn't it?
Yeah, well, no, definitely. I've not seen you for a few weeks, and I've got to ask you the comment about Simon Jordan made, that you and Frank are apparently bullying Ben Shalom.
Well,
that be called a bully?
I know. I mean, I think that it's like really weird. Like, when you see the shit that goes on in boxing, if you think that's bullying, I mean, you know, ultimately, I guess what people are talking about is Ben requesting in contracts, as Frank said, that he's in the middle of the photos and I'm not allowed to have photos with his fighters, which is just the most bizarre demands. But you guys don't really see that side. You just see this guy going, oh, everyone's against me, oh. But it's like, and then he steps in front of Frank. Like, Frank's Frank. He's going to, if you stand on his toes, he's going to push you out of the way. So, look, there's no barriers to working with anybody at the moment for a Riyadh season. So there's reasons that people don't get on, and that's because of the business etiquette and the way people operate and behave. So Frank and Ben seem to have this beef at the moment. Whatever, we're just focused on delivering great shows around the world and looking forward to many more ahead in Riyadh season, and of course particularly Saturday night.
Well, speaking of Riyadh season, I've heard rumours about February the 22nd, AJ Dubois 2. Is there any confirmation on that?
Or? I mean, AJ's confirmed to us that he wants the rematch. The issue is time. You know, if he's going to fight February 22nd, he really needs to start camp in the next few weeks, which is very difficult to do because he's got a few niggles coming out of that fight and it's come around very quick. I think the general advice will be to return in sort of May or June, which may allow them another fight for Dubois in the interim and may allow us to watch closely for December 21st and see what happens with Mr. Fury. So I think we're still in a great position and no decisions yet.
Well, Daniel Dubois, if he is to take another fight, could you see him fighting someone like Joseph Parker?
I think Parker's the only fight, really. I think it's a very good fight. I think Joseph earned his stripes, you know, with victories over Wilder and Zhang. Mm-hmm. It's a good matchup for Dubois, and yeah, that'll be a tremendous fight.
Adam Azim, O'Hara Davis, I've got to ask, obviously, with Dalton being one of your fighters. What did you make of that? Did you expect the fight to go the way it did?
Yeah, I did. I mean, look, O'Hara, you could tell from a week, he's done. Like, you know, it was always going to be his last fight. Adam Azim's a good young fighter. You know, there's no beef there. It's just I wish they'd be a little bit more honest about the Dalton Smith situation. They know they can't beat him. Mm. They should just say it, you know.
And they've said that Adam Azim says that he doesn't need Dalton.
But the fight was ordered by the British Boxing Board of Control and the EBU. I mean, Dalton doesn't need Adam Azim. It's just a great fight. Don't you want to make a great all-British fight that sells out an arena? Mm. Like, you know, they said, we don't need Dalton, he's not a world champion. Well, what was O'Hara Davis? I mean, he just got beaten around by Ismael Barroso. It was about 94. So, like, it's just hypocrisy all round. But I get it. And if I was ducking a fighter, I would be saying the same kind of things as Barry McGuigan. it's okay to duck a fighter. They know Adam Azeem is not as good as Dawn Smith. Let's just get it out there, plain and simple, keep giving him the easy fights, and one day, hopefully, they want a challenge.
Well, just while we're on Riyadh season before, I've got to ask you about Bivol Poturbiev. Mm. Very controversial. I mean, I had Bivol winning.
It was quite mixed up. Like, on the night, around ringside, I couldn't find anyone that thought Poturbiev won, right? On Twitter, and some people watching on TV, there were definitely, I don't know, maybe it was 80-20, something like that. There were people that felt Poturbiev won. When you get in the ring and you hear the three judges' scorecards and not one judge has given that fight to Dmitry Bivol and one judge has given him just four rounds, I just lost my shit, honestly. Like, I couldn't believe it.
I did see that.
But that's what you're going to get from me.
Yeah.
I'm never going to like just bite my tongue. I'm emotional, I'm passionate, and I'm always going to tell you how I'm feeling. And I felt we deserved to win that fight. Robbery is a harsh word. Because I get, you know, for me it was 8-4 to Dmitry Bivol, maybe 7-5. And maybe if it's 7-5, then it's actually, you know, a close fight. But it just, for me, he was completely controlling the fight. Gave away a couple of rounds late, but, you know, I was disappointed that we never got any support from any of those judges. Mm. It's like Madrimov-Crawford, another really close fight. Not one judge had it close.
Yeah.
Like, everyone else is saying, whoa, it's like that, it's like... You know, and when I got in the ring, Dmitry Bivol and his team went to me, yes, yes, they never went, what do you think? Which is what everyone says when it's close.
He's so humble.
I looked over at Poturbiev, they were like this, the whole team. They told him in the 10th round, you have to knock him out to win this fight. They knew, but.
It was weird because Spencer Oliver had it that Poturbiev had won, but then people in the studio were saying that Bivol had won, like Johnny Fisher fought Bivol.
The problem is, yeah, you can't, people are like, he was the aggressor. So what? What do you mean he came forward more? So what was that, winning the fight? Like, you win fights by landing punches and scoring punches. You don't win fights by walking forward and just hitting gloves. So anyway, it's done now, but I felt we deserved to win the fight.
Two final questions from me. Met Pep today, and the Man City team. Do you think your Soccer Aid performance perhaps put him off signing you for this season?
I'll be honest with you, like, a lot of the guys, Foden, Grealish, Stones, I feel like the conversations that we had was on a level, a baller level, do you know what I mean? Because they saw me at Stamford Bridge, and I think I've really gained a newfound respect from footballers and Pep. I mean, Pep doesn't just look at me as a boxing promoter, he looks at me as someone who can obviously play the game as well, because he saw that, you know, so great to catch up with the lads.
Already got, we've got the January transfer window.
Yeah, who knows, anything's possible.
You might have to switch it for a little bit. And finally, Boxing Now are associated with boxers in need that help fighters after their career, you know, with money and stuff like that, and if they've got an injury early on and they have to stop their career. Where would you like to see the money go to help boxers after their career?
I think really, sometimes when money is required to fund something, could be a charity, could be a hospice, could be an amateur boxing club, could be an individual who's, you know, left the sport early or, you know, without intent. It's not just about handing over a donation, although that always helps. It's about trying to provide sustainability for the future. So a lot of what we're doing with amateur clubs at the moment is, yes, we'd like to give you a donation, but that donation is going to last 6 months, a year. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We need to build the foundations for the future so that you don't have to keep asking for those donations. Do you know what I mean? And that's the same kind of thing. So whilst we've got to look after them, we've got to try and build a future for them, whether that's education, whether that's apprenticeships, whether that's coaching in boxing, whether that's, you know, training in boxing. And if they're not able to do that, maybe something else, do you know what I mean? But I would like to see the money go into making sure that financially it can help them, but also trying to give them a passion, build an interest to actually have a sustainable future.
Well, thank you so much for your time,
no problem,
as always. And we'll see you tomorrow.
See you soon.